In this video, I will explain what is transactional processing in ASABAP and what is the difference between database transaction and ABAP transaction, that is SAP transaction. The term transaction. Transactions are processing units that functionally belong together. They have four principal characteristics. The initial letters of these characteristics together form the acronym ACID. A means atomic, C means consistent, I means isolated, D means durable. Now let us look at what is atomic. Atomic means that a transaction is either fully successful or does not have any effects at all. If a transaction-oriented system goes down, you need to ensure that inconsistent partial results are not stored in the database. Consistent means that the system status changes from one that is accurate and consistent in business terms to another that is also accurate and consistent in business terms. Isolated means that the changes made within a transaction can only be seen by other transactions, even those that run simultaneously after the final confirmation, that is commit. The results of a transaction are durable because after the final confirmation, they are stored permanently in the database. So these are all the four characteristics of a transaction. This transaction belongs to either database or SAP transaction. Now let us look at what is the difference between database transaction and ABAP transaction, that is SAP transaction. In the SAP systems, every work process is connected to a specific communication partner at database level for the duration of an SAP instance's runtime. Once the SAP instance is started, each and every work process is connected to a specific communication partner at database level. Work processes cannot exchange communication partners at runtime. At runtime, work process will not exchange the communication partner of database. This is why a work process can only make changes to the database within one database transaction. A database transaction is in accordance with the ACID principle. A non-divisible sequence of database operations at the beginning and end of which the data set on the database must be consistent. Always the data set on the database must be consistent. Before transaction, how it was? After completion of transaction also, it should be in the consistent state. The beginning and end of a database transaction are defined by a commit command. When the commit command is successful, the data will be stored in the database permanently. During a database transaction between two commit commands, the database system itself ensures that the data set is consistent. The database system itself takes on the task of restoring the data set to its previous state after a transaction has terminated with an error. If any transaction is terminated with an error, the partial results are restored back and the data set will be reset to its previous state, that is consistent state. Business transactions are processing units grouped to provide a specific function. These processing units execute changes to the database that are consistent and make sense in business terms. Typical examples are credit and debit updates, which only make sense together. When these two transactions are done together, then only that makes sense. Are creating an order and reserving the relevant material. While creating order, you should have the relevant material available. That is reserving the relevant material. You will reserve the material for this particular order. So both the transactions will be done at simultaneously, that is done at a time. Correspondingly, an AS ABAP transaction is defined as a non-divisible business process that must either be executed completely or not at all. AS ABAP transactions are implemented as sequences of logically related dialogue steps that are consistent in business terms. Every user dialogue step is represented by one screen image. Every user dialogue step is represented by one screen image. When the user screen is displayed, that is dialogue step. Before displaying the screen, process before output will be done. This particular processing will be done within the SAP system. And once the screen is displayed and input is entered by the user, and when the user is clicked on save or switch to another tab, then the process after input will be executed, and then process before output, and then the screen. In this way, different steps are there. Okay, each step has the dialog, that is database transaction, DB transaction. Here also DB transaction, DB transaction, DB transaction. All these transactions combined AS ABAP transaction, that is SAP transaction. Let us read this theory, you will understand clearly. SAP transactions are not necessarily executed within one single dialog work process. SAP transaction, entire SAP transaction is not necessarily executed within one single dialog work process. Within a transaction, that is within a data, within a SAP transaction that changes data on the database, the user requests database changes using the displayed individual screens. Whatever the screens displayed, with that help only the data will be changed in the database. Once the transaction is complete, the changes must result in a consistent database status. Consistent database status must be maintained. The individual dialog steps can be processed by different work processes. Individual dialog step can be processed by different work processes. Work process, that is called work process multiplexing. And each work process sequentially handles dialog steps for unrelated applications. Each work process sequentially handles dialog steps for unrelated applications. Applications whose dialog steps are executed by the same work process one after the other cannot run within the same database transaction if they are not related to each other. Therefore, a work process must start a new database transaction for each dialog step. Okay, so number of database transactions are involved within a ABAP transaction. If the ABAP transaction is failed in between, all the database transactions will be rolled back to the previous state. So that is the difference between database transaction and ABAP transaction. I hope you understood about this particular topic. Thanks for watching.